everybody, this is Eric Worre, and welcome to NetworkMarketingPro.com. I'm excited because today I'm going to start a five-day training series on how you can change your life in 90 days. I've learned over the course of 24 years in network marketing one very important lesson, maybe the most valuable lesson I ever learned. 90 days can change your life. 90 days can turn everything around. One focused 90-day burst of energy that's well thought through, well planned, and well executed can take you from invisible to average, from average to extraordinary, from extraordinary to a legend. You can become a legend. You can become a name over the course of one 90-day period of time. I have coached and trained hundreds of people to change their life over the course of these 24 years, personally, one-on-one. And over the course of these five videos, over the next 5 days, I'm going to coach you on the fundamentals of what you need to do in order to be able to put together a 90-day game plan that can change your life. It happened for me twice in my career. The first was in 1992. I was struggling in network marketing. I was not achieving my goals, and I put together a 90-day game plan September of 1992, and October, November, and December, I worked like my life hung in the balance over the course of those 3 months, and over the next 12 months, I went from being nobody in network marketing to having a 1099 of $980,000. In that year, all from that 90-day burst of energy. It made me scratch my head and wonder why I didn't condense my efforts into a 90-day burst earlier than that, because up until that point, I've been working reasonably hard and plodding along. What I've learned is slow and steady doesn't win the race. You need a burst of energy, and then you can maintain it, and then another burst of energy, and then you can maintain it. The burst of energy is a 90-day burst. People constantly overestimate what they can do in a week or a month. And they underestimate what they can get accomplished in 90 days if it's thought out. It happened to me again in 2005. I had some challenges financially. I had invested all of my money into a business that, a non-MLM business that did not succeed. So I found myself in a tough situation. And in June of 2005, I launched another 90-day game plan, another 90-day burst. And over the course of just the first 90 days, I made $83,000 in commissions. Over the course of the next 6 years, I made $7 million in commissions. Almost every penny of it can be pointed directly back to what I accomplished in that first 90 days. I've trained other people. One example is a guy by the name of Art Napolitano. Art is the top income earner in a major network marketing company today. But when I first met Art, Art didn't have any success. He didn't have any money. And he came to Chicago, drove from Boston to Chicago, met with a friend of mine and myself. And he said, "Tell me what I got to do. I'll do whatever's necessary." And we said, "You know, the only thing between you and becoming a millionaire is putting 1,000 people in a room 90 days from now." And he said, "Really? Because if that's the ticket to be, freedom, I'll do it. Tell me what I got to do." So we spent a couple hours laying out a game plan, very specifically. And he didn't have 1,000 people 90 days later, but he had about 600-700. And today, he makes approximately $5 million a year in commissions. $5 million. From nothing. And I would tell you, if you talked to him, if he pointed back to what created his future, it was that season, that little, and he's done other 90-day game plans since then. I have so many friends that have gone on to make $100,000 a year, $500,000 a year, $1 million a year, or more, all pointed back to the 90-day game plan. So what I want you to do, just understand in this first video, is that what I'm going to share with you is real. It's possible. You can do it. And I'm going to show you how to do it step by step. I'm going to give you all the major components. And your life can change. You don't have to crawl through network marketing. You don't have to struggle. You can change your life. You can, if you're frustrated with yourself, we can give you some direction, okay? So that's our first video. Just a little introduction, a little taste. One of the first things that you need to do as you start with this process is you've got to create some specific goals. In other words, why are you going to do what you're about to do? Because you're going to need to sacrifice. We're going to talk about that sacrifice tomorrow and the next day and the next day. We're going to need to sacrifice over the course of these 90 days. But what are you doing this for? What is your end game? Some examples. You might want to do a 90-day game plan to go to a new rank. Maybe you haven't gone to the rank you want to get to, or maybe you've been stuck at a rank too long, you want to break through. But sometimes a rank, maybe there's a convention coming up and you swore you're not going to, you know, go to that convention unless you're walking across the stage. You know what I'm saying? You should go anyway, but you know what I'm saying? A rank advancement goal can be a powerful goal. Two, can be a team goal. Maybe you want to grow your team by 100 people or 500 people or 1,000 people or 10 people or whatever. You want to grow your team. You want to see your team rank advance. Maybe you can combine those two. How many people on your team could you get to the next rank? So it could be a team goal. Three, it could be cash. You might need to make something happen. When I started in June of 2005, I needed money like oxygen. I had to make something happen. So when I put together my 90-day game plan, yes, rank advancement was important. Yes, team was important. But I had to get some cash coming in the door. So, and you can combine these. Cash with rank advancement plus your team. Get your team making more money. Get your team rank advancing. But you need to write all these things down. Maybe it's a prestige goal. Maybe you just want to be somebody. When I first did it in 1992, my first real 90-day game plan, I wanted to be somebody. I wanted people to know me. I wanted to become known in network marketing. I wanted to have success, because prestige isn't just for you. It's for the team. Because if you have prestige, the team has more confidence to go out there and do what needs to be done. They could proudly say, I'm on this person's team. I'm on that person's team. So it helps with their recruiting. It helps with all of their efforts. These are just some ideas. But what you need to do is you need to write down, what are your goals? If you could accomplish anything over the course of a 90-day period of time, within reason, what would those goals be? In 90 days, what would those goals be? It might be a personal recruiting goal. It might be a rank advancement goal, it might be a team goal, it might be money, financial goal, it might be prestige, it might be a lot of different things. I don't know what it is for you. But combination maybe of all of these things, but I want you, before I give you, over the course of the next 3 days, the three major steps to the 90-day game plan, I want you to take a minute and write this down. Write your goals down. Get them clear in your mind. What would it mean to you if you accomplished that goal? What would it mean to you if you weren't crawling in MLM any longer? What would it mean to you if your team was proud of you? What would it mean to you if you had more cash flow coming into your home? What would it mean to you to get to that next rank or to sponsor 20 people? What would it mean to you if you make that happen? Okay? So write that down. One of the most critical and often overlooked areas of the 90-day game plan. And when I talk about 90-day game plan, sometimes people just say, oh, I'm starting mine tomorrow. Worst mistake you could make. The worst mistake you can make. Let me tell you, the most powerful part of the 90-day game plan is pre-launch. Your pre-launch phase. The time before you're going to start. See, during that period of time, you can be unbelievably influential. You can grow your team. You can... A lot of people think pre-launch is just when you're thinking about it. No! You're going to have a very detailed description of what it is you're going to do when you launch on March 1st. And your job during this pre-launch is to recruit as many people into that campaign before March 1st starts as possible. So I'll give you an example. If I was to talk to you and I was pre-launching and I was getting ready, I was going to launch on March 1st, and I call you on January 2nd, I say, listen, we have to sit down and we have to talk because I'm about to launch something amazing. Now, it's not launched yet. I'm going to launch March 1st, okay? I'm going to launch March 1st, but let me tell you about the plan. On March 1st, we're going to do this, we're going to do this, we're going to do this. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be exciting. Right now, I'm putting together the inner circle of people who are going to help with this campaign, this description of this campaign. Here, let me sit down with you and let me show it to you, the description of this campaign. And I promise you, if you talk about something that you're about to do versus something you're already doing, your recruiting will go through the roof. You'll be able to recruit 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 people personally by just telling them your story of the detailed description of what the campaign is going to be. You understand what I'm saying? Do you feel the power of that? The power of the pre-launch is an awesome force. See, I can go to somebody and say, look, I'm putting together my inner circle for this launch, March 1st. And I'm looking for people who are serious. And excited and engaged and can see the vision of what we're talking about with this description of this launch. Now, after I show it to you, is it compelling to you? Yes or no? Are you in or out? Yes or no? I'm looking for an inner circle. You want to be part of the inner circle? Because I think the inner circle is going to do very well financially. Yes or no? Yes, I am. I want to be part of the inner circle. Well, here's what it's going to take for you to be in the inner circle. You're going to need to do this and this and this and this and this. And you create a little checklist of things that they need to do. They've got to sponsor some people and they've got to get some tools and they've got to sign up at the program and they've got to get themselves on an auto ship or whatever. They've got to get themselves engaged in the process and they also have to create their little team. So now you're in or you're out. I'm in. Okay, we're going to be doing this before our launch. And our launch is going to go from March, April, and May all the way until June 1st. Okay, that's our 90-day game plan, but here's the things that you need to do. So you see, now if you use this detailed description to create your inner circle, and I promise you, once you write down this detailed description of what you're about to do, and you'll understand that tomorrow when I talk about the launch, the details of the launch, then you can create your inner circle very easily. And you can motivate and inspire them to create their inner circle quickly. So imagine if you're able to sponsor, by telling this detailed description, between January 1st and March 1st, you're able to sponsor 20 people. And I promise you, you can do that. I promise you, you can. And you can teach those 20 to each create an inner circle of 10. Now you have 220 people on your team on launch day. On launch day. 220 people on your team engaged, motivated, with you, excited. They're going to roll through this 90-day game plan with you. Do you see the power of doing that? It's so much more compelling than calling somebody on March 5th after it's already done. They don't feel like an insider as much. They don't feel special as much. They don't feel scarcity as much. They just feel part of the group. But this group, the inner circle, created in pre-launch, is amazingly powerful. Now, a lot of this detailed description is going to be clearer to you tomorrow when I go through part four, which is your launch and what's included in the launch and this detailed description that you can tell to people in pre-launch. Okay? I hope this is inspiring to you. If you're the person that I hope you are, you're getting kind of fired up. You know what I mean? You've heard the stories of what other people have done to change their life. You don't want to crawl anymore. You've set your goals. You can see the power of this that you never thought of before. And you're getting fired up, right? Now, one more thing and then I'll wrap up for today's show. Some people say, well, when's a good time for me to start my pre-launch or to start my launch? Sometimes it's when people just get started and they use this process to start their business. Or sometimes it's just you deciding that now is my time. You've been with a company for whatever and you've plateaued and you're not growing the way you want to. You just draw a new line in the sand and you tell a compelling new story. You know, up until now I was just screwing around, but let me tell you, on March 1st, here's what I'm going to do. Are you in or are you out? And tell this, you know, basically the same story, but with a fresh mindset inside your existing. And I've seen some people succeed with all of those different scenarios. Okay? So whatever your scenario, we can create a template that'll make this work for you. The pre-launch phase and how it is the most powerful phase to get people engaged, to do personal recruiting, and to develop a strong and powerful and excited and motivated group when you launch on your launch day. Today I want to talk about launch. The typical launch. The most efficient, I believe, is 90 days. Some people have done 30-day launches. I don't think you get enough traction. Some people have done 60-day launches. Those have worked. Some people do 100 days. But I believe 90 days, people can get their mind around a 90-day game plan. 3 months where they're going to focus. The best 90-day game plan starts March 1, I'm just using that as a placeholder. Ends something like June 1st. Pick your month, pick your day, but 90 days. But at the end of the 90-day period of time, you do a big event. The event is the glue that keeps people focused. You do a big event in your market, and it's the glue that keeps people excited and motivated and focused and working. Because all of the efforts from March 1st to June 1st are going to be putting people into that event. Remember I told you a story about Art that put 600 or 700 people into a room in 90 days? And today makes $5 million a year in commissions? I can tell you person after person after person have used the 90 days to lead to a big event. Okay? So you got to, if we start here with the end, that says, you know, we're going to do our 90-day game plan and we're going to put X number of people into this event. And you might pick your goal. It might be 100 people. It might be 200 people. It might be 500 people. It might be 1,000 people. If you have a big group already, it might be 2,000-3,000 people. Have people fly in and drive in from other cities. But go crazy. You got to be thinking about what you're going to be doing and what your goal is for that event. And is it compelling and exciting? Okay? Because then you're going to reverse engineer the 90 days to figuring out how you're going to get people into that room. Remember I told you the story that if you go do a compelling pre-launch story, you can recruit 20 people. And those 20 people could each go out there and recruit 10 people. Well, what if you sold 10 tickets to your all 20 people? That'd be 200 tickets, right? And those 20 people who each got 10, you know, so that is, 200 people. 200 people, and they each got 10 tickets. That's 1,000 tickets. And your whole job for 90 days was to match up people with tickets. And everybody's job was to make sure that they had 10 people in that event. What would that do for you? If you're able to get 20 and they're each able to get 10, you could get 1,200 tickets into prospects' hands or into distributors' hands and into that event. What would that do for your life? What would that do for your business? Is this possible to do? Of course it's possible. Can you do it? Of course you can. Now, maybe you don't get 20. Maybe you get 10. Maybe they don't get 10, they get 5. But you still got whatever that is, half, 600 tickets sold to an event like that. You see what would happen? So once you determine your event goal, the next thing that you need to determine is you've got month one, month two, month three, and then you have event. Okay, month one, month two, month three. What needs to happen in order to make all this stuff possible? One, you got to sell tickets. Two, you need to recruit. Right? Three, you need to motivate and inspire. Right? Four, you got to keep people focused. So in month one, maybe you get together with your inner circle. One time a week. And just keep them focused, keep them motivated. Maybe you have a monthly training. What's that training going to be about? Getting more people involved in the campaign, getting more people to the big event. Right? Maybe you need to do weekly group opportunity meetings. Maybe you need to promote home meetings. Maybe you need to do webinars. Maybe you need to do conference calls. Maybe you need to get together and have everybody have a blitz day where they just do three-way calls together for the entire day. But you see what I'm saying? Month one is all out. Month two is same. Month three is the same. It's all leading towards this focused end game, the event. Now, with this, let me tell you what it takes to really do a game plan like this. What it takes is all-out massive action. And hold on one second. I'll describe it to you here in just a moment. Let me tell you what it took for me to change my life. All-out. Massive action. This is the part where I might lose some of you. But if you want to change your life, something's got to change. If you want things to get better, you got to get better, as Jim Rohn would say. All out massive action for me meant this. Every week I had to go negotiate with my family and negotiate with my friends and loved ones and say, listen, for this 90 days, I'm not going to be available. For this 90 days, I'm going to be working as many hours as I can possibly stay awake every single day. For this 90 days, I'm not going to the movies. I'm not going to restaurants. I'm not watching any television. I'm not surfing on the internet. I'm not doing anything but this game plan. So for me, I was full-time both of those times. I'll tell you full-time and part-time what both of those looks like. Full-time for me, I'm just going to be honest with you, was 16 hours a day. 6 days a week. No joke. 16 hours a day. I started at 8 a.m., finished at midnight. Every day. Pounding the phones, making the calls, getting people involved, keeping them excited, keeping them focused, helping them recruit, three-way calls, meeting with people, game planning, training, webinars, conference calls, three-way calls, whatever I had to do. All day. 16 hours a day. If you're part-time, let me tell you what that looks like. 8 hours a day times 6 days a week. Work your job for 8 hours and then do this for another eight. Well, that's hard. Yeah, it is. But the results are worth it. You move everything out of the way. You negotiate with the family. We'll go on vacation later. We'll have fun later. But right now, mama's got to work. Papa's got to work. I'm focused. I got to close the door and I got to do some things. I love you. But I got to do some things because I love you. For things to change, we've got to change and I'm going to change. This is what I'm going to do. Pound it, pound it, pound it, pound it, pound it, pound it. Relentless. Because if you're at 100%, then your group might work at 80%. But if you're working at 50%, your group's going to be working at 20% or not at all. 90 days can change your life. Remember what I said? 90 days of this, and your life can be changed completely and forever. Or you can just continue to do your 2 hours a day or 1 hour a day and cross your fingers and hope to recruit a monster. I think this is a better plan. 90 days, everything can be different. Okay? Tell your story. Team action, communication, motivation through this entire all-out massive action process. Okay, there's a lot of detail to this. I don't have time in this training program to give you all the detail, the exact map of this, but I think you can get the idea, right? You know what all-out massive action means. So your launch, 90 days. Pick whatever the period of time, ending with an event. Okay? If you sponsor 20 and each of them sponsor 10, you can and sell 10 tickets to each one of those people, and their job is to fill it up. That's 1,200 people. And then you have to map it out. You have to map out exactly, day by day for 90 days, what you're going to be doing. Week by week, month by month, you have to have a specific business plan, like you were trying to raise money and you had to sell this idea to somebody. That's what you're doing when you're selling this idea to your prospects. Here's what I'm about to do, and here's the end result. Are you in or are you out? We can change our lives in 90 days. Are you with me? This is the story you're going to be telling, right? The story's got to be amazing. And then it's all out massive action. And there's going to be different kinds of people in your group. There's going to be people who are willing to do this with you. There's people who are going to be willing to give you an hour a day or 2 hours a day. Love them all. Really motivate the ones that will go with you, even if it's the 8-hour type. Really go after it. Success isn't free. And success isn't easy. But it's possible for everybody that's watching this. The event itself, here's what you need to do with the event. You're going to set your goals. You got to find a location. You've got to create flyers. You've got to create an event page on Facebook. You've got to create cool tickets. You've got to get great speakers. And this is where you call your upline. You get the best speakers in your company, in your local market. You call your upline. You call the company. If you tell the CEO of your company that, hey, I'm going to put together 500 people in this room in 90 days. I'm going to change my life and help other people change theirs, or 1,000 or whatever. You'll get a company representative. You'll get top income earners. You'll get your upline to come in and support this. If you show them and you just tell them your story. You tell them your plan. That will recruit them into helping you. And you put those speakers on the event page, on the flyers, on the tickets, and on the promo, and you do everything else. You do what I would say promo work, which is get all the speakers on different conference calls, get speakers to do a video you could put on your event page, get speakers to do a webinar that will promote your event, right? Plus what you're doing. So that's some of the things on just the logistics of getting it set up, right? When you do the actual event, the purpose of this event, get this, the event served its purpose already for what it made people do in the 90 days plus the pre-launch, it moved people into action, so it already created its result. Your job at this event is to promote the next event. That's your job. At this event, to promote the next event. Everything in your lineup should be about telling your story, recruiting people, getting people trained, etc., getting people excited. But you cannot leave that event without promoting the next event. If you do that, you screwed up the whole thing. The next event should be about how long after this event? About 90 days. At this event, you should tell people, here's our plan for the next 90 days to fill the next event with an even bigger venue. You should sell tickets for the next event at this event before they leave the room. You should get people excited and motivated and flyers in their hands. Tickets in their hands when they leave the room. If you do that, now you start another launch process over the course of that 90 days to get that next event filled up. And let me tell you something, the best in the world go from event to event to event to event. 3 to 4 times a year, they go from event to event to event to event using this process. Now, you don't necessarily have to be 16 hours a day for the next 90 days. I found the best in the world do one true 90-day burst a year. Now, they go from event to event to event to event, but they don't kill themselves because it's hard to maintain that focus, keep your relationships with your family and kids and everything else, health, if you're just going 16 hours a day. But the key for leaders is to do a real 90-day burst where you're really working 80 hours a week, right? 16 hours a day, and then make it appear to the world like you're still working 16 hours a day, but you're not. You're throttling back a little bit, right? And then you can gather your strength and do another real launch, but in the meantime, this whole big group of people that you built is going from event to event to event to event. Some of them are start doing their pure 90-day launch. Some of them are just finishing theirs, or they have people in their team that are just starting their next pure 90-day launch.